Hello, everybody, and welcome to Hot Shots. Up first, we have got the president taking on Steve Carter, and out first, here comes the president and the rest of the World Order following him, and then disappearing behind him. Ignore that. They do that sometimes. That's just a thing they do. President repping the SWF on his back. Inaugural champion for Hot Shots. Representing this company with extreme tenacity. Losing his belt and getting his first action since. He's going to have some stiff competition as he goes to the ring. Now we await the arrival of Steve Carter. Accompanied by the reigning champion, Ken Castle. A chance to maybe get a measure of revenge by going after his good buddy, Steve Carter. And at the end of the night, we're going to have a triple threat match in a steel cage to determine the number one contender. But maybe the president can move his way up that ladder with a big win against Steve Carter. One-on-one action, normal rules, win by pinfall, submission, or countout. And a leg drop multiple times. Carter using his strength to throw around, the president using his strength, rather. And showing off, getting caught, standing vertical suplex. Oh! Showing off a little bit of Steve's strength now. And getting the crowd involved and dropping him onto his back. Oh, and the reversal from the president. Now the president letting the crowd know who's in control, but a stiff punch, another one. Now throwing him into the corner. Carter setting him up. And a huge clothesline into the corner. Going for a quick cover. And that won't be a two count. Steve Carter going for a quick cover, trying to get a quick victory. Doesn't matter how you do it as long as you get a win. Oh, what a slam from Steve. And dropping the president onto the top rope. Dodging that one. Quick move from Steve Carter. Now he's got him up on the shoulder and throwing him down on the knee. What a move. Now working on the wrist. Oh, and a two count. Not going to be enough to take out the president yet. Oh, raking the eyes. Stiff shot to the back, and now trying to throw him out of the ring, landing next to his partner, Steve Carter. Steve Carter, oh, and a punch right where it counts. Steve Carter and Ken Castle, both members of Knockenbrecker, and as you see, Young Pug getting a little bit closer to the action, making sure there's no funny business going on as the World Order surrounds the action. Wheelbarrow, face plant. Steve gonna roll back into the ring and then hop right back out, ending that count. Want to keep the action going outside, maybe looking to do a little bit of extra damage on the significantly harder floor. Owen dropped over his back, the reversal from the president. Now the president throwing him at the stairs. Unforgiving steel steps. Young Pug eyeing him like a side of fries. Carter walking around. Taking his time. Rolls back into the ring. Catches him off guard with a Thez press. Now delivering rains of punches to the face. The president going for the pin. Is this enough? No, it'll be a two count. Steve Carter's got a finisher. President's got to be careful here. Oh, and the reversal. President trying to get some offense in. Running neck breaker. And I don't know what that was, but it was cool. Now the president finally dishing out some offense. And an end of days is reversed. Almost hit it on him. Steve Carter setting up the president. Stunner. That's gotta be it. No. They're gonna call a rope break. And he sets it up again. His feet are on the ropes. The ref didn't see it. They call the rope break the first time. He positions the president in front of the ref where he won't see his feet going onto the ropes and gets the victory. Smart move by Steve Carter to get a huge win over the president. Could we see another member of the Knockenbreckers win tonight in the main event in that triple threat match coming up in a steel cage? But first, two people coming off of some pretty quick losses last week. Hunter just got demolished by Young Pug, the Mesmerizer. I'm not sure what really happened. It was so quick. Elijah Gregory making very quick work out of him. But now have a chance to get a little bit of momentum as they go up against each other. Which one of these two is going to get a little bit of a boost? We're going to find out as we head to the in-ring action. And here comes Hunter. Hunter, so small and so technical, going up against the massively outsized Young Pug, really shows the reason that they have weight classes, but never backing down. I'm sure Hunter won the hearts of many people during that fight, as he started to get a little bit of offense against Young Pug, but not a whole lot you can do against him. He steamrolled most of the competition he's faced in the SWF. And now we're gonna see the Mesmerizer. What a personality the Mesmerizer is. As he walks to the ring, you can just feel his presence. Can he translate the look to the in-ring action? Walking the walk, now trying to talk the talk. Normal match, one fall. There is disqualifications, no special stipulations, just good one-on-one action between these two, and Hunter gets under him early and decks him. Hunter ripcord punch to the face. Hunter really liking these punches and now going to some kicks. Hunter, very technically gifted, he's got him. I got his hand working on the arms and now the back. Now raining punches onto the Mesmerizer. And a deck to the face again. Mesmerizer hasn't been able to do anything against Hunter this match. Now continuing to work on the arm and the back. There's that knee drop again. A stomp to the back, another one. A boot to the face. Hunter keeping control of this match entirely. Keeping him on the ground. The crowd trying to will Mesmerizer back into this. Hunter having no part of it though. Knees and punches, kicks, slaps, chops, kicks. Just a furious combination of strikes. And now Mesmerizer finally coming to his senses, trips Hunter, using his wrestling skills to get over the top of him, and now he's got him in something, and it elbows him in the face. Oh, and a knee drop to the arm. Oh, big stomp to the face. More and more strikes to his downed opponent. Mesmerizer might just be catching his breath by trying to keep him there. Oh, and another stomp. More and more stomps to the head. How many more of these can Hunter take? Mesmerizer's feeling it. And he's going to the top rope. What is he going to do here? Oh, he wants Hunter to get up. Waiting. Oh, and a missile drop kick. Going back to the top rope again. Twice as nice. And jumps down, thinks otherwise. I think he realized Hunter saw it coming. Now Hunter delivering stiff shots to the gut. And a couple more for good measure. Really working on Mesmerizer in the corner. Oh, and a huge knee to the face. Oh, and another stiff shot. Mesmerizer's hurt. Oh, and the Mesmerizer putting him in the corner now. Mesmerizer setting him up. Could it be? Oh, it's a buckle bomb. And that can destroy a man's back. He's going to go for the pin. He's got two, but a kick out from Hunter. Back to the top rope. Hunter sees it coming, or does he? It turns into a hurricanrana and a pinfall. No, it's not even going to get to two. Hunter was aware of the pinfall attempt. I don't think he saw that coming. I think he was expecting that drop kick again. Oh, and caught Hunter. Now he's got him in an ankle lock of some sort. Middle of the ring. Oh, and Hunter just kicks him in the face to get out. Desperation move. Now Hunter knows he's in control. Big shot to the face. These two have gone so back and forth. Such huge shots being delivered in this match. You can tell both of these guys really want this W. Hunter finally able to pick on somebody his own size. And in control of the Mesmerizer on the ground again. More stiff shots to the face. Up to the top rope for Hunter. Nails him in the head. Good move. He's got Mesmerizer hurt. He's going to pull him to the middle of the ring. Is he going to go for a pinfall? Yes, he is. Oh, and almost three. Mesmerizer looks like he might not have known where he was for a moment there. Takes a little bit less time to move him into the middle of the ring. He could have had a pinfall. Now Hunter got him up against the ropes. Oh, and a big kick. Hunter's got his finisher. Mesmerizer in trouble. Going back to the same technical moves that has been working on the back and arms of Mesmerizer all match. Sticking to the game plan. Oh, and he caught the foot. Now Mesmerizer's got him. Oh, and just throws him with some sort of suplex. Mesmerizer to the top rope. Oh, a huge move off the top rope. That looked like it could have taken just as much out of the Mesmerizer as it did Hunter. He's going to try to move him to the middle of the ring. He wants that pinfall. Oh, and a quick kick out from Hunter. Determined to stay in this fight. Now throwing him out of the ring. Is he going to go follow him to the action? He will. Hunter reversing him. And a reverse of his own. And a little scoop slam there. Mesmerizer gonna go inside of the ring. And he's just gonna be in there just to break up the count. Doesn't want to win by count out. He wants to pin him or submit him in the middle of the ring. Oh, throwing him against those unforgiving steel stairs. Mesmerizer wants to go back into the ring. I think he's just going to try to break the count again. No, he's just going to show off. Hunter now realizing where he is outside of the ring. He's going to catch Mesmerizer, give him a taste of his own medicine, throw him against those ring steps. Break the count and then come back out. And those ring steps are definitely getting a beating. These wrestlers are being thrown at him repeatedly. And now Mesmerizer using his strength. And an elbow drop to the back. Mesmerizer's got two finishers saved up. Hunter is in trouble. But he's got to get him back into the ring. Very athletic suplex from the Mesmerizer. What a shot. Just dropping Hunter with a right hand. Looks like he wants to move the action back into the ring. He's going to break up the count again. Huge moves outside of the ring. But if he's not going to win by pinfall, he's got to throw him back in. And he's still working on the arm, even outside of the ring. Hunter is looking beat up right now. And another big move outside of the ring. Hunter reversing it, and getting reversed on himself. More stiff shots to Hunter, and he's going to throw him into the ring. And finally, the action taking place legally again. And now, Mesmerizer setting him up. Could this be it? He's got him, and he hit it. That's it. Oh, and a kick out from Hunter. After all the abuse that he's taken, he kicks out at two. now he's going for an ankle lock. Can he get to those ropes? He's got him. He's got a tap. Nowhere to go. And Hunter is forced to tap out. What a match from these two. Epic victory for the Mesmerizer. These two going to war. And that is the kind of wrestling that I expect from these two. Polar opposite of what we saw from both of them last week. Even in the loss, both of these wrestlers should feel good. But that win has to feel really sweet for the Mesmerizer. And we're going to the next match. Bean picking up his win last week. And the Riddler and the Joker retaining their title against Robbie and Ken Castle in the main event of last week's card. Both of these teams riding high are going to have an opportunity against each other now. We saw Jack and the Beanstalk lose their first match against the Riddler and the Joker, the Tricksters, 2 weeks ago, but this could be their chance at revenge. And out first, it's Jack Morgan. And he is just as serious as he looks. Jack Morgan, the strength of his team, Jack and the Beanstalk. Bean, obviously, as you can see from his strut to the ring, is their charisma. The Lady Destroyer. Bean. Just everything about Bean screams swag. Almost like a Beauty and the Beast dynamic. And up next, we've got the champions, the Tricksters. And the reigning defending tag team champions going up in non-title action tonight against Jack and the Beanstalk. Let's get it going. Up first, it's going to be Jack Morgan and the Riddler. Jack able to wiggle out of that one. Riddler with a springboard elbow, it looked like. Just got the back of Jack Morgan. Taking him down now. Got him in a submission attempt, but Jack just using his strength to power out. Oh, stiff shot. Jack's got him up and drops him down on the apron. Jack just pressing him in the air. Look at that strength from Jack Morgan. Oh, and some quickness from the big man. They've got to bring their action back into the ring. A dodge, but an elbow returned to him. Another dodge. Oh, and a neck breaker outside. Six. Refs at a six count. Seven. Pressing him up again and throwing him down. Eight. Jack getting back into the ring. It's an eight count. Riddler at the nine count. Can he make it back into the ring? Oh, just barely beating the count. Riddler keeps his team alive, making it back in and now taking it to Jack Morgan. The champion hitting him with kicks. Flurries of kicks in the corner. Oh, and what? Oh, what athleticism! Riddler now going for the pin. Quick kick out, not even going to get to one. Jack Morgan having none of it early. Now a little jawbreaker to him. Taking him back to his teammate. Here comes Bean. Lifting him up and throwing him down. What a move. Oh, but a quick tag from the Riddler. The Bean didn't see it. Oh, but he catches Joker. Joker and Bean giving each other big hits. And Joker got him up against the ropes. Oh, what a position to have Bean. Oh, and he's not done yet. Huge boot. That's going to send Bean out of the ring. Joker really feeling it now. Bean trying to find a spot where he wants to get into the ring at. Decides to finally roll in. Joker waiting for him. He's going to bring him over near his tag team partner. He's going to go for the quick knee to the face. That kind of offense is pretty hard to guard. Bean with a reversal. Oh, and what a move from the Joker. Jack desperately asking his partner to try to tag him in. Bean reversing Joker. And choosing to stay on him, going right at him. Shots to the face. Now the tag into the big man. Let's see what they got set up here. A huge punch to the stomach. And it looked like he was going for a spear. I don't know if it connected, but he looks like he's hurt. I think that got all of him. Now Jack bringing him back to the corner. Let's see some more tag team action here. Setting him up. Huge shot to the wrist. Bean bringing him back to the ropes. But Joker gets out of it. He's got to be careful. He's in enemy territory with two people who have finishers. Joker's hurt, but he's still dishing out offense to Bean. What a stiff knee. Gonna finally get a chance to take a breather, tagging in the Riddler. Going right back to work on Bean. Huge boot to the face. Oh, and the reversal from Bean. Bean bringing him back to the corner. Now Jack setting him up. And down. That's gotta be it. Going for the cover. Oh, and a kick out from the Riddler. I don't know how he kicked out of that one. But Jack is not worried. This crowd is into it, and a huge knee. Riddler gets back to his corner, gets the Joker in. Knees to the stomach, one after the other. Now going with kicks. Now the Joker's got his finisher. After a quick break, the Riddler's ready to go back at Jack Morgan. Oh, and a quick spear, is that it? No, it won't be. Jack kicks out. And both of these two have been through so much, taken so much damage. Both still able to kick out. These two have to be exhausted. Jack Morgan tagging in Bean. More tag team teamwork. Dropping him on the knee, now working on him on the ground. Bean going for the quick pin. And that's going to be it. Jack and the Beanstalk with a big victory over the champions. You got to question whether or not the Riddler should have still been in there after taking that huge powerbomb only minutes before. Bean and Jack showing off some of the best wrestling we've ever seen out of them. Have a win over the champions. What does this mean for them going forward? We're going to find out in the Discord. And if you're not in the Discord, you absolutely should be. Make sure to let us know if you want to be in there and you're not down in the comments. It's where you can see all of your hotshot superstars, promos, in-character talk, schedule, everything you need to know. But up next, as you can see, the name is blurred for some reason, but we've got Wapo versus Randy the Wrangler. We'll have to figure out the censoring thing. But his name is fine, so we're going to keep it. Randy the Wrangler lost versus Bean last week. And Bean continuing his hot streak. The win against the champs. Randy, a chance to redeem himself against a debuting Wapo. Randy trotting his way down to the ring. And up next, showing off the swagger, it's Wapo. Weighing in at 244 pounds, Beefcake. I don't know a whole lot about this man, but I can already tell, at the very least, he's entertaining. We get set for our last match before the main event. Here they go. Wapo off to a quick start. Oh, wow. Some definitely unique offense, but a little kick to the face from Randy. It ain't much, but it's honest. Oh, and a miss there. Just elbow going directly into the ground. Wapo back on top. And a kick out from Randy. Oh, and a huge boot to the face. Staying on top of Randy the Wrangler. Oh, what a knee. Now to the top rope. What has he got planned? Huge stomp to the gut. Staying on top of him, getting to work. Ref, you need to move. We're trying to sell a product here. You're in the way. Thank you, Hard Cam. Wapo whipping Randy into the corner. Huge kicks. Now Randy, a chance to gather himself, delivering some strikes of his own. Now lifting him up over the shoulder and onto the ropes. Randy going to work on the neck of Wapo. Dodging the punch, throwing him into the ring, or into the corner, and a clothesline, going for the quick pin. Changes his mind, goes back for it again. And just a one count. Randy, I'm not sure if he expected to win, but I think he was expecting a lot more than a one count. Now whipping him by the hair. You can see the frustration in Randy. Oh, and what a throwdown from Wapo. And a kick out at two. He is feeling himself. Randy with a little trip to reverse him. And a reversal from Wapo. Randy in trouble now. Getting thrown into the corner, running Superman punch. And he's not done. There's the spear. Is that it? It is. And the debuting Wapo wins his match against Randy the Wrangler. And what a debut. All right, ladies and gentlemen, up next we've got the main event match. Some reason it went to exit instead of next, so we took a small detour. But Ken Castle saying that these three have the opportunity to fight it out. Winner gets to challenge him, Kimani Cooper, with a big win over the Kenneral manager, me. To debut last week, showing off some impressive resiliency in his victory. Robbie's been very good in general since he's been in the SWF, and Elijah Gregory coming off of a quick victory against the Mesmerizer. All these three coming off of some good momentum, and now a chance to challenge the champion, and that chance comes via a steel cage. And I changed it to Bobby Roode's entrance, but it still doesn't use it. So just imagine that he's saying glorious right now. We'll skip this part. Kimani Cooper making his way to the ring. Kimani, one for one, undefeated record, strutting towards the ring. And now finally, we are going to see Robbie come out. And if there is one man that I do not want to be stuck in a confined space with, it's Robbie. And it's a lot more than just because of his wrestling ability. He doesn't smell very good. Took a lot of convincing to make Elijah Gregory accept this match. I believe his quote was, I don't want to touch Robbie's sweater. But unfortunately, that's the kind of sacrifice that you need to make if you want an opportunity against the champion. Elijah Gregory going right at Robbie. In case you don't know the rules of this match, in order to win, all you have to do is win via pinfall or submission against any of your opponents, or escape the cage and let both feet touch the ground, whether it be via the door that is locked shut or climbing over and out of the cage. Elijah Gregory looking around as Kamani Cooper keeps going to work on Robbie. Now Kamani Cooper on the shoulders of Elijah Gregory, dropped onto his stomach, onto the knee. Robbie taking it to Elijah Gregory. Kamani showing off to the crowd, but Robbie taking advantage, thinking about leaving. Kamani looks at him, thinks, no you don't, not sure where you think you're going. Stiff shots to the back. Oh, but here comes Elijah Gregory. Takes out him, Kamani from behind. Realizes that Robbie hasn't stopped climbing the ring, or the cage. Robbie continuing to try to climb, eventually slips off, his greasy hands finally coming back to haunt him. Now going to work on Kamani Cooper. Huge knee to the face. Robbie trying to climb out again. Cooper having none of it. Robbie not a very skilled climber, it would seem. I'm sure he's climbed fences to trespass many times, but maybe not a chain link fence quite this height. Now Robbie's feeling himself. Oh, and just throwing Elijah Gregory at the cage like a lawn dart. Going to work on Cooper, and now Elijah Gregory working on the leg. Now Robbie letting this happen, but you gotta be careful. If anyone taps out to your opponent, that means you lose. You have to win via pinfall, submission, or escape. So if somebody else wins that way, even if it's not against you, you're done. Just a back and forth match between all these three. Nobody really able to gain the upper hand. Elijah Gregory just sitting back and basking and watching his opponents hurt each other. Now he's gonna try to take it to Robbie. But Robbie, slippery as ever, gets behind him. And just throws him at the cage again. Dropping Cooper on the turnbuckle. Oh, Robbie didn't see Elijah Gregory from behind. Driving the face of Robbie into the ground. None of these men looking like they can get any kind of advantage. Here's some double team action against Elijah Gregory. Temporary alliance and a quick breakup from Robbie. Cooper wisely trying to take advantage of the situation, go for a quick pinfall attempt. Now he's just going to try to take out the trash, but no, Robbie slips out and hits him in the calf. Oh, what educated feet from Elijah Gregory. Oh, and what's this? Gregory continuing to show off the athleticism. Gregory is spinning whatever that was. Throwing around Cooper. Elijah Gregory is on a tear right now. Robbie continues to slip out of everything, going for the Superman punch, but Elijah dodged it. What a move from Elijah Gregory. Kamani doesn't see him from behind. And a reverse, a DDT from Gregory. Now quick three count. He's going for it. And hoping to get that count, but only got to one. And a Superman punch from Cooper. Could this be it? And a kick from Robbie is going to break up that pinfall attempt. Robbie keeping the combos coming against Kamani Cooper. Now taking it to Elijah Gregory. Reverses it. And all three of these men have finishers. Fall away slam. Now Elijah Gregory thinking maybe he can sneak out of the cage. Kamani Cooper having none of it. Going to work on the legs. Oh, but Elijah Gregory kicks him off, but Robbie's going to try to stop him now. And falling to the mat. Gregory's escape plan has failed. Kamani with a huge headbutt. Oh, and a spear from Robbie! Oh, and that could have been it. Elijah Gregory stopping the three count. Huge shot from Robbie. Robbie's going to try to climb out of the cage. Both of his opponents on the ground. Can he make it out? Robbie making his way to the top, and now Elijah Gregory also making his way to the top, trying to stop Robbie. But Kamani's going to go try to climb himself. All three of these men in a precarious spot. Robbie on the top of the cage, kicking down Kamani Cooper, but here's Elijah Gregory. Oh, trying to pull him back down. Robbie wisely dropping back to the ground. Oh, dropping him onto the turnbuckle. More offense coming from Robbie. Everyone's got finishers. Everyone's hurt. Everyone has to be on their toes. You don't know who could be trying to climb out or who could go for a pinfall or maybe submit at any moment. He's got Gregory by the hands and just drops the knee to his back. There's pandemonium in this ring right now. But what a wheel kick thing from Robbie. Robbie suplex, and he's not done. Ripcord, lariat. Now setting up Elijah Gregory, and got him with a knee to the face.